Today we're working on the upper link brackets for the K5. I made these, I started making these the other day, and then I don't like them. I decided I didn't like them.
That is a lot of metal.
Yeah. Well, not really. I mean, but so I thought I had a decent design, but then I was looking at it and I was like, it looks kind of, this is the one that was on there before. And I don't know. I don't want to use really thick metal because it's really expensive. So I'm going to make it like geometrically strong. So it's going to use thinner material, but more webbing. But anyway, I just didn't, it looked clunky and out of place. So I didn't like it. So unfortunately I wasted these plates, but that's okay. It's all in the development and discovery. So over here is what I actually ended up finalizing, which is, so basically I got my brass knuckles right here, reinforcements right there. And then, let's
see. That is what they look like.
I know. That's what I'm gonna call them, brass knuckles. So this goes against the frame side there. And I wanted it to not look square and boxy. So I don't know, I just want to give it some design, some feature. So it goes like this, like that. And then this one's supposed to go like this. And then this one's supposed to go on top like this. Now it may need to be massaged a little bit just so it fits better. Looks like it needs to be a little bit. It almost fits perfect. I think I have one actually that it was grinding on. There we go. So it goes like this. Let me get my hammer.
What do you think so far?
Yeah, I like it.
Like it?
Mm-hmm. It looks better. Can I ask a question?
Sure.
Why the circles?
I'll tell you right in a second. So that's kind of what I envisioned. It's not fully seated, but it's kind of... So this is the outside. This part gets welded to the frame. And then these deals here are going to get TIG welded on the face of this. And the purpose of that is to reinforce the loop.
Mm.
So we're going to have bolts go through.
Oh, I see.
And so if I explain this properly, if you put a thick, let's say we went with a 3/8 plate and it's about this thick, the whole thing is, you know, that large, you don't really need it to be thick all the way through the plate. What you need to do is actually just reinforce the actual the loop where the bolt goes through, and that makes it really strong. You know, so right here, basically what we effectively is, what we have is a half inch plate right about here, and then the rest of it can be lightened because it has a lot of surface area.
Right.
So you don't need a thick plate all the way across. So that's, yeah.
And that looks nicer.
It looks nicer, stronger. More aesthetically pleasing. And it's what we call it, geometrically strong. So you use the shape and size of the part, the features, to make it strong, like a honeycomb, versus having just a big thick flat plate. So, and then on this side here, I'm gonna make another plate that's gonna go around the back side of it to actually close it up. So, and I'll probably put, Andrew suggested put some two speed holes here. So that's probably what I'll do. So I'll get all tacked up in place, both brackets, and then weld it together, and then mock it up, make the back plates, and then tack it to the car.
Thank you.
Yeah, your project.
You making progress, Drew?
Yeah, so I got the brakes done on both sides. They used to be drums, as you know. And then I got all the suspension dialed. Everything's all tightened up. And got the brake lines hooked up on both sides. Had to make some brackets for the brake bias. And the brake lines on that side.
Didn't so you have to show you? Didn't you have to clearance the frame a little bit more on, for those bags?
Yeah, so like I thought they cleared at first, but the bags, the way they were angled at full droop, it was stretched the wrong way. So it was basically like this, and it needs to be more flat. So I spun them to where they should be, but it ended up pushing it back towards the frame a little bit more, so I had to clearance it. So I had to do that on both sides, but that's all good, put back together. Shocks are on. I had to modify the sway bar end links because it would rub on the bag up here on this bolt. Mm-hmm. See, you can see the spacer is pretty short.
Are you gonna cut that stud at the bottom?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll end up cutting that, but I haven't had time. So this used to be all the way up here into the bag, so I had to drop that down in order to get that to not rub. Alright, so does it need light?
Need to be a little bit. Yeah. Back up, dog. Back!
Alright, so I made this bracket.
Oh yeah, much nicer.
So that I can mount this little manifold here. And then I bent the brake lines. I had to drill and tap another hole for this bracket to be here for this this hose, brake hose. And then up top, I got the brake lines for the front brakes and then the rear brakes back here. I made that bracket for the brake bias. It's hard to see at that angle, but easy to get to and not out in the open.
Nice.
Why don't you tell the people what the brake bias is intended purposes?
It's to basically give, it's supposed to adjust the pressure to the rear brake so it doesn't skid. Pretty much. What else? Yeah.
What else do you want to tell the people?
Any
hiccups or problems you've had?
We were trying to bleed the brakes, and there was no flow on the back line, so we had to figure that out. Pretty annoying because it happens pretty much every time.
It puts you in a. I was in a good mood up until like, what, 20 minutes ago? 20 minutes ago?
Maybe.
So, what was happening is he called me over because he said that he couldn't get any fluid to the back lines. And I thought that there was. Sometimes these cars have like crust built up in the bleeder valve and there's like mud in there and stuff. So, I thought that maybe that was the issue. But that wasn't. So we ended up taking apart the lines up until there's one line that goes from this brake bias adjustment valve, one line that goes always to the back, and then it tees out into two. Well, there's when it tees out into two, it goes into a soft line, and that line is what the problem is. But that bolt was so freaking hard to get off. So
irritating. Up a little bit.
So irritating. So you can't get a. What's called a box end wrench on it because it has to go through the tube. So it's a wrench that looks like this. It's a flare nut wrench like this. So it slides over and it's kind of like a C. But even that would not take it off. It just stripped out the bolt. So now we have to replace both lines on both sides and probably the main line to what he just did.
What?
Yeah. Because it's so crustified.
Is that old though? Is that
one? I mean, it's original. I mean, it's not original, it's like...
It's
at least 34 years old.
Yeah.
So
that's probably original.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. If you look at, so over here is the line that came off.
This freaking piece of trash right here. This thing is so hard to get off. So there's no fluid coming out. So basically, the single line comes from the front bias valve to here, and then it goes out here, and then it goes to a T, and there's a left and the right, and it wasn't coming out here. So we broke it loose here, and that's where it stripped out. It's like the nut is in the frame. You can't even get to it. It's very difficult. So we broke it loose there, and then it just started dripping out. So, yeah, this is the culprit here.
Were you like, what the heck is going on? Or did you realize you missed that?
This happened once before. I forget on what car.
6.2.
Another Impala?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He tells me. Yeah,
yeah, you're right. It was.
What's that?
Can you tell I was getting pissed?
A little bit.
I got the upper link mounts done. And if I must say myself, it came out pretty damn good. We start earlier in the day and there was just a pile here of parts.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's like a Lego, kind of goes all together.
Looks like a transformer.
Yeah. So I got everything TIG welded. I put this back plate on to stiffen everything up. Andrew had a good idea. He suggested that I use dimple dies.
Eight holes.
To kind of give it some style. So then I had to, I had a little snafu. Basically, when I went to put the end link on this, the uppers and low, all the way, because it's supposed to be five adjustable spots, right?
Mm-hmm.
When I put in this one, it was hitting the top. I forgot that I didn't have enough clearance. So I had to go and fix it. So basically now, now it fits. So it has good articulation. But yeah, that took me like an extra hour just to do that. But yeah, it has to be perfect, right?
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, so that's the left and the right. I can bring it over and mount it to the car so you can see the truck, I should say.
Mm-hmm. The Blazer.
The Blazer.
The Beast.
The Beast. So what I'm gonna do is later, I'm gonna MIG weld the inside here and here because you can't see it. Just TIG welding is cool and it's super strong, but so is MIG welding. And the deposition rate for TIG welding is a lot slower, so it takes a lot longer. So it's better just to throw some beads in here. You can't see it, so
mm-hmm.
It's just as strong. It just doesn't look as cool.
But so you can't see it.
You can't see it anyway. It's no value add. Goes like that. Just goes on like this. If it didn't fit.
Knowing you made sure.
Yeah. So it'll be like this, basically. Just like that.
Nice.
So Andrew's gonna come through and he's gonna weld all of this. When do you think you'll be able to do it, Andrew?
I'll probably do it tomorrow. I'll see why not. I think I could probably work on it tomorrow.
So yeah, that's how it's gonna go.
One on each side?
Yeah, one on each side.
Nice.
I was struggling with the design. I really didn't know if I should go with a design that goes from left to right, like a bar. I don't know. But I think I got something good now.
I like it.
Like it?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. All right. So yeah. So that's for tomorrow, or one of the next couple days. I'll have Andrew weld this in, weld everything in, and then mock everything back up, and then put the transfer case in.
How far are you from finishing?
I'm probably within.
Still another month.
No. Well, as far as the rear suspension is concerned, I'm within days of finishing that.
Okay.
So I just have to weld everything in.
So then you still gotta do the front?
Yeah, but the front is not nearly as complicated.
Okay.
So the front's, I'm just gonna have to massage the way it's set up. Might make some tubes, but it's not gonna be, this was like really bad to begin with, so.
The front's not too bad.
So.
But yeah.
Yeah, pretty good. Eric will be happy.
Yeah, I think so.
It just takes time, man. You got all these projects that we have. We're just kind of, you know, just touching everyone every couple weeks.
Every weekend?
Yeah. So, I think we got a good handle on it now. So,
I'm excited to see it all done.
Yeah, it's going to be pretty cool.
It'll be cool to see, you know, that day when it just gets to sit on all fours.
Yeah. That'll be super cool.
Not bad. It was hard, actually.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Why? I don't know.
It was
maybe
hard
just the position.
Oh.
Because I can't see the puddle that well.
The pedal, there's no pedal, that's why.
Puddle.
Oh.
Because the gun's in the way.
Uh-huh.
So I'm kind of just going by feel.
Imagine having the regular helmet on.
Yeah, it's too big to have in here.
Yeah.
I'd have to, like, be over here.
What matters is you get a good penetration, mm-hmm. and it's concave.
Where's that helmet from?
I bought a couple.
What's it from?
Last year.
I've never seen you guys use it.
It's only for special occasions.
Oh. We've used it, like, one other time.
You got both sides done or just that one?
No, I just started.
So you're welding it on. That means it's permanent.
Yes, yeah, now. So what you could do is actually weld the backside, clamp this side over here,
mm-hmm.
and then you don't need to clamp at all, and then you can just do it. I would do a couple tacks in the corners,
uh-huh.
just to make sure it's not moving around.
Okay.
And then it's a nice day today.
Yeah, it's really nice actually.
It's a nice day for welding. Can you see well enough with that?
Yeah.
Okay. With that tack?
Yeah, it's just a tack right there, so it doesn't lift up.
Yeah. Do that more, like 90 more times. Do a plug weld.
Okay.
What's that mean?
Like one of these.
So you want to start in the center and just work, let it kind of fill up for a second and then kind of work your way. And then as soon as it becomes co-planar with that top surface, you're done.
Why do you weld those? For extra support?
So, extra surface area. Everything happens at a surface.
Should I do this real quick?
You can.
So it doesn't.
Yeah.
Should I put a clamp here or not?
No.
How do you know if you run out of welding wire?
Because it'll stop welding.
I know, but you'll still have a light.
No, you won't.
It'll stop completely.
The light comes from the arc.
It's pretty good, Andrew.
If I was to critique it just a hair, what I would say is you were a little low.
I mean, we're splitting hairs here. But
like down here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just a hair.
Because it's all wavy.
So what happens is because you're welding on an edge, this has a tendency to melt away first.
Okay.
So you bias it maybe 20 or 30 thou above that and then let it flow down. But that's still good. I mean, like I said, we're splitting hairs. So.
What's that mean, splitting hairs?
Like you're making something out of nothing. Like, if you were to get really granular, like, detailed, that's what it means.
Should I do these first?
I would do
or
a couple
next,
of those.
I mean?
I just want to see you do a couple of those.
Okay.
Then I can go and do what I was doing.
He's your apprentice?
He's my practice. Perfect. There you go.
See.
It worked.
Great. Dude, why are you always hungry? Huh? It's only a banana. Bananas aren't even good for you. Right?
He don't care. He wants it.
You like a banana peel?
He probably would eat it, yeah.
Hey, no dummy.
Alright, that's enough. There's no more. Alright. Are you done welding the welding on the K5?
Tell us what you did.
Yeah, so.
Oh shit. If you were barefoot, dude, that'd be so nasty.
It'll be even funnier if you slipped on it.
So I welded this face first.
Face first?
Yeah. Welded the outsides first. Had to use clamps. So I clamped it up top, as you saw. And just went from end, this end, then, you know, opposite side, and then just switched off on each side.
Looks good. So did you do both sides?
Yeah, then I went to, did the back. I had to use a clamp to bend that side to the frame.
And are you going to TIG weld these? These, relief cuts?
Yeah, we'll TIG weld these, and then, I can't see it over here, but this cut right here, well, I'll TIG weld that.
Oh, you can see it. Actually, there's a little bit of piece left. That's a good weld, Andrew.
Oh, thank you.
Who taught you how to do that?
Me.
Actually, I taught him how to TIG weld a little bit, but I think he probably learned most of it at school, right?
I don't know, actually.
Took you
all day. I don't really practice a lot of welding.
Really?
No, not at school.
Yeah. So now that this is done, let's mock this up and see where the appropriate location is going to be. Just like that. So now we can actually mount this for the final and last time. So that's cool.
You gotta weld it to it?
Yeah, we'll MIG weld it. I'll have Andrew MIG weld it. After he'll have to TIG weld this relief cut, and then we can put this in place. And then start finishing up on the tube nuts, front and back, the left and right, and then the shock tower mounts. And then everything can start going back together.
Cool. We had a transmission leak.
And it was leaking out of the speedometer cable port. And it was, for weeks, it was dripping. It was driving me crazy. So I dropped the pan, and then I made a huge mess, as you can see by all this charcoal ash on the floor. So watch out, dog. And then, so I made a big mess. So then I went to Napa, and I finally got one of these bigger pans that leads into this. So now when I do a transmission job, it won't make a huge ass mess. Because everybody knows that's ever done a tranny job.
Honey, you've been doing tranny jobs for how many years? And you just now got one of these?
Yeah.
How much did that cost?
Was that 500?
Liar.
Cents. And that was like 50 bucks. No, it was like 30 bucks. But so, change a pan, filter, and then I put some O-rings. I had to rebuild the speedometer port. I had to put a groove in it and an O-ring in the actual little gear. Because mm-hmm. I don't have one, so. But then, Andrew, I just need you to go over everything, all the bolts, all the nuts, just a final sanity check, make sure everything is tight where it needs to be, and then we're gonna run the line.
What are you doing to the transmission?
Just changing the pan, the gasket, it leaked, mm-hmm. so it was just, it was time, it was due. Run the lines to the back, and then start hooking up the solenoids, the surge tank, for the camera, you can see all the bags, the control arms, brakes, shocks. So looks pretty good. Do you ever show the back too?
I'm not sure. I don't think so.
Show them from the back.
We got the bags in there.